Now we are going to discuss the last step of cellular respiration, that is oxidative phosphorylation. So till now what we have discussed, the glycolysis, pyruvate decarboxylation and Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle. We have got NADH2, FADH2 molecule. Now it's time to convert that NADH and FADH into ATP. So how this NADH2 or FADH2 is converted into ATP, we'll discuss in a detail. So for example, like in Krebs cycle, we get 6 NADH2. We'll take an example of 1 NADH2. So this is complex 1, complex 2. All the complexes and protein associated with electron transport chain I have discussed in my previous videos of electron transport chain. So 1 NADH2 will oxidize through complex 1 and form NAD+. So it will release 2 electron and 2 proton, 2H+. Now these 2 electron will be accepted by FMN, that is flavin mononucleotide of complex 1. Now this FMN will pass electron to FES, a complex of iron sulfur. Now this FES will pass the electron to Q10. Q10 is also called as ubiquinone. Now this Q10 will go and give electron to cytochrome C of complex 3, and the process continue, and the cytochrome C will give electron to complex 4. So finally the electron acceptor of electron transport chain is oxygen. So only one molecule of oxygen, so we write half O2. So now this half O2 plus 2H will give water, H2O. So we'll get oxygen will convert into water here. So finally the electron acceptor of electron transport chain is oxygen. So now all this process I have discussed, but how ATP is generated, let's discuss now. Similarly NADH2, in case of Krebs cycle we get 2 molecule of FADH2. The same way as in FADH2, we'll get oxidized to FAD+. Here also same 2 electron, 2H+ will be liberated. Now this 2 electron will same in process of complex 1, in the complex 2 also it will pass and it will give electron to Q10. Now the same process repeat. Q10 will give electron to cytochrome C. Now cytochrome C of complex 3 will give electron to cytochrome C of complex 4. Now the oxygen will accept the electron. The final electron acceptor of electron transport chain, remember, it is oxygen. Now all these processes going on, now what is happening is, so we have three pump. So complex 1, complex 3, complex 4 act as a proton pump. So whenever the electron pass here, as we know about physics, whenever the electron pass we liberate some energy, and that energy is required for pumping of this H+ ion through the complex 1, complex 3, complex 4. So here H+ ion is there. So in complex 1 it has a capability of pumping 4H+, 4H+, 4 proton. Now complex 2 just act as a enzymes, so it doesn't pump the proton. So complex 3 has the ability, while electron is passing, the same energy is liberated and that energy is utilized for pumping of the proton. So 2H+, and complex 4 have the ability to pump 4H+, same as complex 1. So finally all the NADH or FADH molecule will be utilized to pump the proton. So finally the electrochemical gradient between the two membrane is generated, and that is called as proton motive force. So proton motive force is required for ATP synthesis in electro ETC, electron transport chain. So how? So here we get a electrochemical gradients. Here suppose for example we get 10H+. H+, H+ molecules are there here. So Next, come to the complex 5, ATP synthase. Now, ATP synthase, due to high concentration of H plus will, H plus can only come to the matrix through ATP synthase. So through ATP synthase, H plus will come down. Here we'll get H plus molecule. It will come down. So this concentration gradient is maintained, or concentration gradient is generated, and that will cause proton to come down. So this energy is required for synthesis of ATP. How? This energy will convert ADP plus PI to ATP. As I told you, F1 particles of ATP synthesis is catalytic domain. It will convert ADP to ATP, and the energy will come from the concentration gradient, where protons will come down, and that energy will mix the ADP plus one phosphate group, and it will form ATP. So this is the finally we get the ATP. So as I discussed in the first videos of cellular respiration, one molecule of NADH will give NADH2 or NADH plus H plus will give 2.5 ATP, and one molecule of FADH2 will give 1.5 ATP. Now it's time to prove how this one molecule of NADH or one molecule of FADH will give 2.5 or 1.5 ATP. So remember, four protons is required for one ATP. So in this case, we get 4H plus from complex 1, 2X plus from complex 3, and 4H plus from complex 4 in case of NADH2, because we are considering NADH2. So we get 10H plus, means 2.5 ATP. Suppose we will consider this FADH2. This is, I am considering NADH2. Now, if I consider FADH2, so in FADH2, it is not associated with complex 1. So we will calculate only complex 3 and complex 4. So 2H plus and 4H plus, that is 6 proton, and it will give 1.5 ATP. So hence we proved that 4 proton is required for 1 ATP. So for 1 NADH it will give 10 proton, for 1 FADH it will give 6 proton. So 4H plus will give 1 ATP, 10 will give 2.5, 6 will give 1.5. Now it's time to discuss about the grand total, which we discussed in the first video. One glucose molecule will give 30 ATP. Now it's time to discuss how the one glucose molecule will give 30 ATP. So first, remember, in case of Krebs cycle, we get 6 NADH. So 6 NADH2 and 2 FADH2 and 2 GTP or ATP. So if we'll multiply this into 2.5 or 1.5, it will be 15 ATP. It will be 3 ATP. It will be 2 ATP. So on a complete set of Krebs cycle, we'll get 20 ATP. Now we'll discuss about the pyruvate decarboxylation, that is occurring in mitochondrial matrix. There we are getting 2 NADH2. So 2 NADH will give 5 ATP. Now we'll discuss about glycolysis, that is the first step. This is pyruvate decarboxylation or preparatory step for Krebs cycle after glycolysis. Now glycolysis, The glycolysis, I have discussed in the first video, it will give 2 NADH and 2 ATP. So finally, if we'll add all, 2 NADH will give 5 ATP and 2 ATP. That equal to 7 ATP. So finally, if we'll add from Krebs cycle 20, from pyruvate 5, and from here 7. So it is 32 ATP. But I told you, one glucose molecule will give 30 ATP. How we are getting 32 ATP? Because, as you remember, glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm. So the NADH2, the two molecule of NADH, what we get in cytoplasm should come into matrix for association with this oxidative phosphorylation. So to get the 2 NADH from glycolysis cycle, we need, or we spend 2 ATP for that. So 1 ATP for 1 NADH. So in glycolysis we get 2 NADH. So we spend 2 ATP to come. So finally, we'll write 1 glucose molecule will give 30 ATP. So why 30? Because 2 ATP is required for bringing the NADH from glycolysis, that is cytoplasm, to mitochondria. And a subtle system is there in mitochondrial membrane, and that required ATP for opening, and it will bring the 2 NADH of glycolysis from cytoplasm to matrix. So the next, all the procedure continues in oxidative phosphorylation. So with this, we completed the entire topic of cellular respiration. We have discussed the introduction, next the glycolysis, then pyruvate, how pyruvate convert into acetyl-CoA, then it will come to Krebs cycle, it occur in the mitochondrial matrix, and finally the how one glucose molecule is giving 30 ATP we have discussed. So I hope you like the series of video of cellular respiration. So if you like the video, please like my videos, and please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.